75.
What's small?
50, 75. 50.
Welcome back. Thanks for being with us. Four players remain on this final table, and the payouts are steep. So if you're just joining us, it's a good time to be tuning in. $85,800 going to the next person eliminated. $122,105 is to third. $177,680 is to second. And first place, $279,000. Appreciate you being with us. Dave Farah, Tyler Patterson here at Thunder Valley, and just outside of the Sacramento area, it looks like we're going to start this new level, 30-75K on the small blind, big blind, ante of 75,000. With a couple of nice starting hands, so Jake going to raise it up to 175,000 with ace-10 offsuit. Tony's going to three-bet it to ace, with his ace-queen up to 400,000. So first pot here before the flop, already almost a million chips in the center. And this should create some fireworks, an ace there in the on the flop, and both players getting a nice piece of that.
This is the final four of 250 players here. They've been playing four-handed for quite a while, and right when we come back from break, it looks like there's some serious action going on.
1.2 million already in the center. Tony is going to lead out there with 275 after Jake makes the check, and he is going to call 275 to a turn, which is a three of clubs. Tony's still very much in control here. Jake first to act, checks over to Tony. Also checks. And a four of hearts drops on the river. That means Tony's hand is best. Both players again with an ace in their hand.
Could see a blocking bet from Jake here or just a bluff catch. I would expect Tony to bet for value now. 1.5 million in the pot. Jake has 1.9 million left. Maybe $500,000 or $600,000. Could go for less.
$600,000. Yeah, you nailed it. And quick call there from Jake. Bad news for him. 1.3 million behind now for Jake, and Tony once again up over 5 million in chips. Huge pot. I mean, that's almost 3 million chips.
Yeah, that was one of the biggest we've had.
Yeah.
So Tony's a returning champion. He won one in Jacksonville, Florida. Jake has 7 World Poker Tour final tables, but no wins yet.
The elusive win still hanging in the balance for Jake, though. He's had a couple of close calls looking at the blinds here, and Tony up top, 68 big blinds for him. Robert with 35 has managed to muscle his way back in. And 17 for Jake, followed by Kevin at just 14. Kevin sat down as a chip leader, maintained that chip lead throughout much of it, has had a couple of really rough hands as of late, and the blinds are going up, up, up. So interesting times for these four players. Like you said, we've been playing four-handed for quite some time, about 6 hours into this final table so far, and Tony has done a nice job of being on the brink of elimination a few times, muscling back, has got the chip lead now. So again, blinds at 50, 75 with an ante of 75. Robert on the button, 8-3, says goodbye. Kevin here in the small blind. Suited connectors, 5-4 of hearts. Pot's already at 200,000. He's only got 975 behind. Will he want to hang around here?
All in.
Sure does. Says all in with 5-4 of hearts. And Jake is going to step out of the way, and Kevin is going to scoop up those blinds, which are significant at this point. That puts him in third, almost 1.2 million in chips, 16 big blinds. Not a lot of room to work, though, with 16 big blinds. So we'll see how long we remain four-handed, but it feels like it's coming down to it, doesn't it?
It really does, yeah. That was a nice win with five high, though.
pretty good. Robert's out of there with his 7-3. Kevin on the button this time. A king and a four of clubs. 1.2 million behind. So he's thinking about another move.
All in.
And he sure does. Goes all in again. Jake with not much going, and he is going to get a look up here from Tony with his ace jack. And, boy, that's just about as bad news as you can get if you are Kevin. All in here for his tournament life. 2.4 million chips in the center, almost 2.5. So Kevin manages to pull out a miracle here, and he'll be right back in this thing, but going to need to dodge a major bullet. Ace, jack of clubs for Tony. To a flop we go. Heads up. And a jack and a couple of queens in the window. That is just not great news. So Kevin looking for that king. And only the king at this point.
King or running straight. That's really all he's got. Or a couple of fours.
And here we go. There's a nine. So some hope there. There's tens now that are in place. Seven outs. Kings and tens. Final card to come. Will this be it for Kevin? A jack on the river. And that's going to do it. It's a boat for Tony. And Kevin is going to walk in fourth place with $85,800. Great performance by him. Just had a couple of big hands not go his way, Tyler.
Yeah, there was a couple of really cool ones from him, too. That Jack 10 bluff was pretty awesome. He made a couple of good laydowns. And, he played really good today, really well.
So Kevin Robichaud going to walk in fourth place with $85,800 off just a $5,000 buy-in. And now we are to the final three. Everyone walking with at least six figures. So third place, $122,000. Followed by 177,000 and 279,000. And Tony way ahead here with 84,000 after he takes the remaining chips from Kevin. Robert with 35 still in the mix. And Jake going to need to make some moves here with just 14 big blinds remaining for him.
You can see the cup glowing in the background there. They're all trying to get their name on that WPT trophy.
You bet. The cup awaits. And only three players remaining. Starting with 250 in this tournament, and as you've mentioned a couple of times on this broadcast, but it bears repeating, that Kevin has been at seven WPT final tables.
Jake
has been at seven WPT final tables, and he has yet to win himself a championship. So even though he's a short stack right now, he's played really well at this final table. So gets a couple of hands to go his way, and he's certainly right back in the mix.
Yeah, he's got the coolest storyline. But Tony Tran also, he's a former WPT winner, so he's going for his second. And
he's had all his chips a couple of times in the center.
Right. And Robert coming over here from Germany for a little West Coast swing trip, checking out LAPC and
steal all of our women.
I wasn't going to go that far, but yeah, maybe.
I know what he's doing here.
He got to see a little bit of the national parks. He was telling me he saw Yosemite.
Six figures playing poker for whatever reason. To a flop we go. It's a 7, a 5, and a 3. So Tony right now still has the best of it with his 10-9. Gut shot there for Robert.
That's a pretty good spot to bet for Robert.
He'll check and to a turn, which is an ace of diamonds. Tony's still best with 10-9. Another check.
Neither player is going to try to credibly rep the ace, I don't think.
Well,
I got both of Robert's actions wrong on this hand, so that's good.
250,000 from Robert. Well, it'll work. 725,000 is the scoop there. So, don't think that's totally insignificant for Robert and his stack as he continues to try to navigate his way back into contention to potentially get two heads up here.
Yeah, every little pot like that matters now. $122,000 is the next one out. Not too bad.
Yeah, it's pretty nice payday, right? I mean, you think about $5,000 to start, and you know, not such an unmanageable field with 250 people starting this tournament out, but turning $5,000 into $122,105, that's pretty good stuff, and you see why these guys are at this final table. And let's not forget, Tyler, for those that are just tuning in, you were close to this as well. You actually went out in 10th, and I know that you're not going to brag on yourself, but, I mean, that's an impressive run for you too, man.
Yeah, it was close. Thanks. Tony got me in 10th, so kind of makes me feel like if Tony wins, it kind of feels like second, you know, like the best team.
When your team in football loses, but then that team that beat you goes on to win the Super Bowl, you're like, see?
Yeah. We could have won it.
We could have won. Yeah. Just ran into that buzzsaw. Granted, we only had 3 wins in the season, but still.
Well, what team are we talking about? Are you excited about the Las Vegas Raiders?
Sure.
I'm not going to be your team?
No, I mean, they're the home team, right? So, yeah. I mean, I'll root for them. I'll enjoy going to games and stuff like that. The team that I grew up rooting for is the Minnesota Vikings, so you're talking about two different divisions and, you know, conferences and everything else. There's plenty of separation there. So
that's easy.
Yeah. Oh, so this could be interesting. So Robert's going to raise it up to $175,000 with his King Jack, and Jake sitting here with $850,000 back. Looking down at a couple of jacks.
Yeah, it's certainly going in. It's just
there he goes. Makes the call. He's all in. Tournament life is on the line. Tony quickly out of there with his 9-3. And Robert could grab these chips from Jake. So this is significant. 1.95 million in chips in the center here. This would bring us to heads-up action. And unfortunately, potentially end this run for Jake, who has been at so many final tables for the WPT, hasn't managed to get that victory just yet, but obviously an enormous accomplishment, even if he does go down here. But it's not over yet. He is currently leading in this one with his jacks right now. So let's see what happens. 67% that Jake's jacks are going to hold. To a flop we go. There's an ace, there's a 9, and a 4, and Jake's still good, potentially going to double up, and him and Robert would have virtually identical chip stacks if that's the case. Robert's going to need a king and a king only in order to stay alive. A deuce falls on the turn. No help there, just 3 outs left for Robert. Otherwise, Jake going to be right back in this thing. Final card to come. Here it is. It is a 10, and double up for Jake. Now has 2 million in chips, and Robert down to 1.9. So that would have made things real interesting had Robert scooped that pot and then would have been heads up between him and Tony, because would have evened things out. But again, 3 players very much in this thing, and Jake with 2 million chips, still plenty to play, and big win there for him in order to stay alive in this tournament.
Yeah, it was a big hold for Jake. Important pot in the tournament.
So you see how even it is. Tony way up top there, 82. 26, 25. Sunglasses go back on for Robert.
Were they off there? Is that what happened?
Yeah, straight up.
What was he thinking? Dancing on my own. And that'd be like Tony turning his hat back around. It'd be a terrible play.
Can't do that. Strategically rub the chicken wings together at the right time. Coming live from Thunder Valley Casino Resort in Lincoln, California, just outside of Sacramento. It's a short, about 25-minute drive from Sacramento Airport, and 3 players remaining with $279,000 up top. Jake is going to jump out of that one. Tony in the small blind with a great starting hand here, 3-handed, ace-queen offsuit.
One, eight.
I didn't think so.
Tony's asking Robert how much he has left.
1-7, maybe.
They're playing 50-75 are the blinds.
All in.
It's a pretty big all in.
Tony going to move. Robert.
Going to get a fold from Robert. Yeah.
He's out of there. Tony now north of the 6 million chip mark, and he is starting to run away with this thing.
Jake. That's me. Put your card in the box.
You're wrong, buddy.
Put it in the box?
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
And if Tony eliminates the next player out, it is going to be an uphill climb for whoever has to face him heads up.
Right. He does have most of the chips, and that would give him overwhelming chip lead.
I immediately told you I have a much better hand than I should ever have here.
C-A-L-U-M, Scott. I like that song. It's on YouTube. It's very inspirational to me.
All right. Tony will be first.
Tony on the button, 5-4.
He's first and searching for inspiration.
Well,
just pass on that. In the small blind, Robert, 8-7 offsuit.
Kind of an interesting dynamic with the two-thirds of the big blind, small blind. It makes that happen a lot more. You can't really fold, so you're going to be limping a ton, so you might want to limp some of your good hands, too.
Robert with the call there. Jake with his 10-4 off in the big blind. Raise it up. 275 to go now. Robert's going to pass. Nice move by Jake.
Jake realizing that you have to limp almost everything.
Tony.
Especially when Simon Cowell presses the buzzer at the end. Golden buzzer.
Whoa.
America's Got Talent? I love America's Got Talent.
What's going on around here?
Guilty
pleasure.
You gotta listen to that song. That's
I'm like a season and a half behind.
Now are they broing down about America's Got Talent? What is
it? It's wild. They're talking about how much inspiration he gets out of Simon Cowell pushing the buzzer.
I mean, don't get me wrong. They do a good job with the editing of that show, but it's always like, you know, someone comes out on stage that had the odds stacked against them, and they managed to overcome, and it's beautiful. Robert making the move here all in with his Oh, boy.
That's a good reaction.
Oh, man. Yeah, so he's going to hate this. So Robert with his deuces up against Tony's tens, and Tony nowhere near at risk here, whereas Robert has put all of his chips in the center, 3.4. So if Robert can manage to pull out this miracle, he'll be in pretty good shape and even things out a bit with Tony. But Tony in a commanding position right now, as you see the percentage is 82% to take down this pot with his overpair.
It looks like we're heading to,
all right, here we go to the pot.
Heads up with Jake's storyline.
An 8, a 9, and an ace. That means Robert has a deuce and only a deuce that can help him at this point. A 3 rolls out.
Very close.
Close. That doesn't count in poker, does it?
Well, we need a black deuce. He needs a black deuce, not a red one.
And here we go. Final one is a 4. Close again. Doesn't get there. And Robert is going to make the walk with $122,105. And it is down to 2. And like you said, the storyline remains. Jake, who has never won himself a WPT despite 7 final tables, will have the opportunity to do just that. But this final table run has been great for him, but what a challenge he has in front of him with Tony having so many chips.
Big uphill battle going up next.
Who is going to win the 279th?
All right, here we are. Heads up for the WPT Rolling Thunder title.
Big blind here, small here.
Jay Schwartz and Tony Trent.
And we welcome you back as we are heads up. Tony Tran, 107 big blinds, over 8 million chips. Jake Schwartz, 26 big blinds, just shy of 2 million chips. And this is not the first time that we have seen these two square off in heads up action. In fact, Tyler, you actually called that final table. And these two, I mean, Tony has been responsible for one of the 7 trips to the final table where Jake has had to leave without a WPT champion's accolades as well as the top prize. So he's been so close so many times, still has an opportunity here and a nice starting hand for heads-up play.
Right, I had forgotten about that. I knew that, you know, Jake's record, and I knew Tony won in Jacksonville, but I forgot that they played heads-up in Jacksonville even though I was on the mic.
These tables go long sometimes. It's all right.
They run together, you know.
So here comes the flop, and Jake getting the better of that. He's got top pair with the jack kicker, and he's going to lead out with 100,000, and Tony is going to quickly let it go.
And in that last heads-up battle, they actually had even chips a couple times. They traded leads a couple times, and then it was just a big queens versus nines all-in pre-flop that Tony won, and that put Jake at like a 10-1 disadvantage, and it was pretty much over from there.
So Robert Heidorn, he was the last to walk with over six figures as well, $122,105 for him. Walking in third place, now the runner-up is going to find themselves pocketing a very healthy $177,680, and the winner, $279,270. And their name's going to go on the side of the WPT Cup. They get entrance into the Tournament of Champions, which is coming up in Las Vegas. And Tony looking down here at another couple of cards that he's probably not thrilled with to start out heads up. A 5-3 offsuit. Jake has got himself an ace and a four. And Tony is going to make the call. 75,000.
The blinds are 50 and 75, so 50 on the button and 75 for the player in the big blind.
Ante of 75 as well. Pot of 2 1/4. Here we go to the flop, and it is a 6-8-9. Jake still best with his ace high.
Jake was trapping there, not raising with the ace out of position, but that flop's just so bad, he just gave it up.
Thank you, Frank.
It's 30-minute level, but
it will be the next level. It's the level
long. You can see the Thunder Valley Poker Room director there, Ben Irwin, in the background, standing back there with a cup, calling the action.
Yeah, Ben's great, man. Always a pleasure to work with him. And I know that this poker room, this casino, near and dear to your heart. You're a Sacramento guy for many years. And this casino, Thunder Valley, just about 25 minutes away from downtown Sacramento.
Yeah, it's pretty nice and a good place to be.
Tony with a 10-3 off. Jake looking down at King 9. Jake's going to make the call here. Flop comes, an ace, a 10, and a 4. So Tony gets a pair of 10s, middle pair, on that flop. Jake's going to lead here with 75,000 after a check from Tony, who will call.
Just because King 9 is likely the best hand and every pot's important, so Jake's going to try to win it here.
Jack rolls off on the turn. So some possibilities there for Jake. Queen rolls off.
I don't think he's going to get Tony to fold anything better than his hand, so he's going to check back.
And a 4 comes on the river. Tony's 10s are good with the 4s and the ace as the kicker. Jake hoping for some showdown value. Not enough, 375,000. So a couple of small pots to get things going here in heads-up play.
We talked about their dynamic with the bickering and the buddy, the frenemies, mm-hmm. Dynamic. And yeah. I forgot that probably stems all the way back from Jacksonville.
Yeah, and that it probably leads right into that play that we had earlier where there was pretty nice bluff to get Tony off the better hand, a big bluff by Jake. So, yeah, the history is deep between these two, and what a moment to if Jake's able to pull it off here, he's got a long way to go, obviously, but if Jake can pull this off and get some vengeance for getting knocked off of another final table by his buddy Tony, that would be something.
That was a pretty sweet hand, that play Jake made with the check raise with the king high, the king of clubs.
Oh.
Jake with just over 20 big blinds, going to check back.
A 9, a 6, and a deuce roll out there on the flop, and a check from Jake. Tony checks as well. Jake's king still good at the moment. A 5 comes out. $150 is the bet from Tony. Jake will check out. Tony takes down another pot, albeit a small one.
Every chip you win now, heads up, your opponent loses also. So even these small pots are pretty important.
Dave Fair, Tyler Patterson coming to you from Thunder Valley, beautiful casino right here just outside of Sacramento, and heads up play as the final two battle it out. Pretty big difference between the top